Shalom, Mashpacha. Shalom, how you doing today? I got a message, man. I got a message I got to bring out today. Shopify, because I believe a lot of us, we trusting in people too much. I think we get putting our trust in man, some of us, too much. That's good. I had to skip the commercial. But the links to the videos is all in the description below. For anybody that been wondering, this instrumental track is played. It's about the Titanic theme song instrumental. They allow you to share it. So I'm playing it because it has a lot to do with this message today. I don't know if you saw the post that I had made earlier today on my community tab. I'm going to read it real quick. It say, realize this. Some will fill up the gas in their car for them. Some fill up their cup for them alone. That's why they don't care if your tank is empty and your cup is empty. Look, some only think tribulations isn't real because they don't feel anything for nobody but themselves. When Titanic was sinking, rich people with privilege to get on the rescue boat were happy. Didn't stop to realize there was only a selection of them who would board them. Ask yourself, if Titanic sinks today, wouldn't people who aren't wise chase those who can feed the planet? But to build a raft with those who choose the creator's ways. Just something I jotted down in case I'm not able to go live today. April 7th, the sixth day AD. Tawada, thank you for sharing, Messiah said, in John chapter 15. He said in John chapter 15. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman, the farmer. Every branch in me that bears not fruit, he take away. And every branch that bear fruit, he prunes it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now, you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can you, except you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me you can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch, and is withered. And men gather them, and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit, so shall you be my disciples. As Abba have loved me, so have I loved you. Continue you in my love. If you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love, even as I have kept Abba's commandment and abide in his love. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you. Henceforth, I call you not slaves, for a slave know not what his Lord do, but I have called you friends. For all things that I have heard of my Abba, I have made known unto you. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go forth and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whosoever shall ask of you of the Father in my name, he may give it you. These things I command you, that you love one another. If the world hated you, you know that it hated me before it hated you. If you are of this world, the world will love its own. But because you are not of this world, but I've chosen you out of this world, therefore the world hate you. Remember the word that I said unto you, the slave is not greater than his master. If they have persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they have kept my sayings, they will keep yours also. But all these things will they do unto you for my name's sake, because they know not him that sent me. If I had not come and spoken unto them, they had not had sin. But now, they have no cloak for their sin. He that hate me, hate Abba also. If I had not done among them the works which none other man did, they had not had sin. But now they are both seen and hated both me and my Father. But this cometh to pass, that the word might be fulfilled that is written in the law, they have hated me without a cause. But when the Comforter is come, you know he was talking about Isaiah, but when the Comforter is come, whom I will send unto you from Abba, even a rock of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me, and you also shall bear witness, because you have been with me from the beginning. These things have I spoken unto you, that you should not be offended. They shall put some of you out of the synagogues. Yeah, the time come that whosoever kill you will think that they do Elohim service. And these things will they do unto you, because they have not known the Father nor me. Shalom, Sister Naomi and Sister Malaka Adaya. But now I go my way to him that sent me, and none of you ask me, where are you going? Because I said these things unto you, sorrow hath filled your heart. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. Amen. Hold on, Mashpaka. What's up, sweet pea?
Okay, I gotta tell you something.
He said, nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. If I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. And when he is come, he will reprove the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment of sin, because they believe not on me, of righteousness, because I go to my Abba and you see me no more, of judgment, because the prince of this world is judged. I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Ruach Amath, the Ruach of truth, is come, he will guide you into all things. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father have are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine and shall show it unto you. A little while, and you see me, and you will not, and you shall not see me. And again, a little while, and you shall see me, because I go unto Abba. Amen. Skip down to verse 19 of Yochanan chapter 16. Now Yehoshua knew that they were desirous to ask him, and said unto him, do you inquire among yourself of that I said, a little while, and you shall not see me? And again, a little while, and you shall see me? Verily, verily, I say unto you, truly, truly, I say unto you, that you shall weep and lament, but the world shall rejoice. And you shall be sorrowful, but your sorrow shall be turned into joy. A woman, when she is in travail, hath sorrow because her hour is come of her dilation. She's about to give birth. But as soon as she is delivered of the child, as soon as she give birth, she remembers no more the anguish for joy that an Adam is born into the world. And you know, therefore, you now therefore have sorrow, but I will see you again, and your heart shall rejoice, and your joy no man take from you. And in that day, you shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, truly, truly, I say unto you, whatsoever you shall ask Abba in my Sham, he will give it you. Hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. Ask, and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. These things have I spoken unto you in Proverbs, but the time comes when I shall no more speak unto you in Proverbs, but I shall show you plainly of the Father. At that day, you shall ask in my name, and say not unto yourself, and I say not unto you that I will pray the Father for you. For the Father himself loves you. For Abba himself love you. Allah loves you himself, because ye have loved me, and I believe that I came out from Allahayim. I came forth from Abba, and I am come into the world again, and I leave the world, and I go to Abba. Go on to John chapter 1, beginning at verse 1. Verse 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Allahayim, and the Word was Allahayim. The same was in the beginning with Allahayim. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of man. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from Elohim, whose name was Yochanan. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many of his own that received him, to them gave he power to become Ban Elohim, sons of Elohim, of judges, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, which is death and sin and condemnation, nor of the will of man, Adam, which is carnality and death, but of Elohim. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. He had real flesh. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of Abba, now full of grace and truth. Yochanan bear witness of him and cried, saying, this was he of whom I spake, that cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. And of his fullness have all we received, and grace for grace. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I got one more I want to show you, family. You can use to create and sell t-shirts. I got some more I want to show you. All right. Turn it to Matthew chapter 15. This is the Bible. Whoever don't like it, they is against the scripture. Go up to verse 22. Matthew 15 and verse 22. Whoever don't like this, they don't like Hamashiach and they hate the word. Whoever don't accept this, they hate Elohim and they hate the word. Whoever hate this, they hate the children of the kingdom. So how can they be a part of the kingdom? Matthew chapter 15, verse 22. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, Yahweh Adonaiah, Ban Dawad, son of David. He is a son of David according to the flesh. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. Listen to this Canaanite woman talking to him from the seed of Ham. But he answered her not a word. He ignored her. And his disciples came and besought him, saying, send her away, for she cried after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Yasharal. Then came she and worshiped him. This is how the Gentiles can receive Messiah. But a lot of them is too full of pride to do this here. Then came she and worshiped him, saying, Adonai, help me. Adonai Baba Kwasha. You know, the Canaanites spoke Phoenician Hebrew, right? Because they was our servants. She said, Adonai Baba Kwasha. She said, Yahweh in Yahweh Shah. She said, help me, Adonai. But he answered and said, it is not meet to take the children's bread and cast it to the kalab and cast it to the dog. And she said, Amath Adonai, truth Adonai, yet the kalab eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table, you know, from their master table. Then Yehoshua answered and said unto her, let's see if he beat her and tied her up with a rope and beat her and took her husband and scratched his leg wide on the horse. Let's see if he did any of this stuff. Look at what Yehoshua did now. After this woman humble herself, for the humble shall be exalted, not the pride. Then Yehoshua answered and said unto her, O Asha, great is your faith. Great is your Amah. Be it unto you, even as you will. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. Herein lays the issues with a lot of Christians and with a lot of people with the doctrines of men. Amah, this is the issue with a lot of people who hold fast to Christianity. They believe that because Yahweh said salvation is of Yahweh die first, and then the Gentiles, they think that because Yehoshua said that salvation is of us first, then that means that he's racist, because a father take care of his household first. A husband take care of his household first. A husband take care of his household first. A wife submit to her husband over any man. But because this is in place, many people don't understand Yahushua. So they boasting against the natural olive branches. They don't even believe in the scripture. They don't even believe in Yahushua. Many of them would rather go to hell and burn in the lake with the snake forever than to believe in what the words say. Because who would have thought that salvation would come to people who ain't supposed to be nothing? To people to whom the world say ain't no good thing come from them people. Did they not say that to Yahushua? About Yahushua? What good come out of there where he was born at, in Nazareth? You know that Nazareth was the hood. Go ahead and turn it to Luke chapter 17. This is for the Gentiles. Y'all better get this before the ship sink. For y'all ship sink, thinking that y'all finna be saved on y'all life rafts that y'all created for y'allself, storing up all of our riches in y'all storehouses. Then he said unto the disciples, it is impossible. Because a lot of Gentiles been saying, well, we gonna get the word. I'm trying to give you the word. I told you yesterday or the day before that, when I went on there, if you didn't listen to what I had spoke on, here you go again, Gentiles. Then said he unto the disciples, it is impossible that offenses will come, but woe unto him through whom they came. Look at the laws that's set up right now, Gentiles. Look at the laws that's set up right now to oppress the poor, a mother and her child, to break up families and homes. How can you enter into the kingdom of life if you stand by these wicked laws and you put on your stupid KKK hats and go around terrorizing people that is broken down? It's like a worm. If it were better for him that a millstone, this is what Yahushua say about people like this right here. And that go for every Sambo, Shuck and Jive, Tap, Shoe, Dancing Negro. It were better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck, and he was cast into the sea, into the deepest part, then he should offend one of these, this my little one. You, a lot of people that's full of pride, might not believe that Yahweh care anything for this downtrodden people. But you better listen to this word before you take your last breath. Take heed to yourself. And they say that the Negro is a monkey. He ain't even my brother. If your brother trespassed against you, rebuke him. So if we got to do this with our brothers, you also Gentiles got to do this. You are not exempt from keeping the law. Take heed to yourself. Play War Thunder now. Join millions of players. Pause this here. Take heed to yourself, Gentile. You better take heed to yourself. Lest you be judged by Elohim for your wickedness or what you've been doing to the children of Yasharal, and don't like the prophets and don't believe in the prophets and thinking you're going to escape judgment because you got privileges. You don't have no privileges that you got in this world right now in the kingdom of Yahweh Shai, that Abba Nabba is going to exalt him and give him. Don't you know that in Psalms chapter 22, it say, Adonai said unto my Adonai, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. The Pharisees came to Yahweh Shai full of pride, like a lot of Gentiles, asking, how is Yahweh Shai Elohim and exalt himself and make himself Elohim? And the scripture said it in our law, that we are the sons of Elohim, the children of Yasharal. And they was boasting against Yahweh Shai's office. Do you think that if those who are of the bloodline did not make it, you're going to make it by being perverse and wicked? You're not going to make it when the ship sank down, Gentile. You're not going to make it. If you don't have Yahweh Shai in your heart and receive our salvation by humbling yourself, you're not going to make it. You're going to be condemned. You're going to be cast right down there. Like one of your brothers said in the pulpit, you're going to be cast right down there in the lake of fire with your slave master fathers if you don't receive the good news of Elohim. That's what the scriptures say. You can't make it in his kingdom, and you ain't got the light inside of you. What did it say in First Yochanan? While a lot of people been boasting against the natural olive branches, thinking that we done away with, and y'all got a religion now set up where y'all can oppress the natural olive branches while y'all claim the inheritance. Why is y'all celebrating Passover? Do you think that by celebrating Passover and keeping the feast, do you think by clearing up your house of all of the leaven, do you think by going, you could go and you could go and slaughter the calf, a male calf of a year old without a spot or a blemish? But Negroes got to go and look on shelves and hope that they have one that is like this. So we trust in Yahweh Shai's grace. We trust in Yahweh's grace through Yahweh Shai. Y'all not going to escape. If our ancestors was condemned because how they treated Yahweh Shai and how they treated Yahweh's Passover and how they treated his holy feast, not that he did not want us to celebrate his feast, but he wasn't delighted in how our ancestors celebrated the feast. The prophet Yeshaya, Isaiah say, what is the fast that I desire? What is the fast that I desire? Many people get so mad, nobody can't say nothing to them. Reprobated to the 45th degree. Don't like to hear the word of Elohim. They trying to get mad at Elohim and making laws against Yahweh. Turn it to Luke chapter 21, verse 8. And he said, take heed that ye be not deceived. For many shall come in my shame, saying, I am anointed. I am the anointed one. I am the Messiah. And the time draw near. Go ye not therefore after them. When you shall hear of wars and of commotions, be not terrified. For these things must first come to pass. But the end is not by and by. Then he said unto them, nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and great earthquakes shall be in diverse places, and famines and pestilence. Was there not a great earthquake in Portugal during the time of slavery? And pestilence and fearful sights, and of great signs shall there be in the Shamayim. But before all these shall they shall lay their hands on you and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogues and in the prisons, being brought before Moloch and rulers for my name's sake. And they shall turn to you for a testimony. Settle it therefore in your hearts, not to meditate before what you shall answer. For I will give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries shall not be able to gainsay nor resist. Ye shall be betrayed both by parents and brethren and kinfolk and friends, and some of you shall they cause to be put to death. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, for my memorial's sake, for my memory's sake, but there shall not an hair of your head be perish, and your patience possess ye your souls. And ye shall see Yerushalayim compassed with armies 70 AD. Then know that the desolation draw is nigh. Here's the timeline that go A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Now we on 21. Let them which are in Yahabadai flee to the mountains. Where is the mountains if you fleeing out of Yerushalayim? In Ethiopia. And let them which are in the midst of it depart out. And let not them that are in the countries enter thereunto. For these be the days that all things which are written may be fulfilled. But woe unto them that are with child, and to them that give suck in those days. For there shall be great distress in the land, you know, in our inheritance, and wrath upon this people. And they shall fall by the edge of war, by the sword, war, and shall be led away captive into all nations. They shall fall by war, and shall be led away slaves into all nations. And Yerushalayim shall be trodden down of the Gabayon until the time of the Gabayon be fulfilled. And there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars upon the earth, and distress of nations with perplexion, the sea and the waves roaring, men's heart failing them for fear. We waiting on this. Looking after the things which are coming on the earth. Remember, Yerushalayim, the capital of Yahabadah, the capital of Judah. The people of Judah shall be scattered into every nation as captives of war in the last days. They shall be the Abid of the nations in the last days. So if they abide, then they had to do some slavery. And there should be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars. We are already scattered. Where our ancestors were scattered as captives, we live in the lands of our captivity. Listen to this. 28. Go up to 27. And then shall they see the son of Adam coming in a cloud with power, with authority, and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your head, for your redemption draws nigh. So the people who were led captive need to be redeemed. Our lands were at peace in all the Shabbats without us there. And we have not been redeemed. Year after year of jubilee after jubilee, we have not been redeemed. Time after time, season after season, that we celebrated the wrong way, we have not been redeemed. Many say we can't celebrate the Passover because we ain't in Yerushalayim and we ain't in the temple and we ain't got this and we ain't got that. Well, our ancestors was in Masrayim, not in the lands of their inheritance, and they celebrated Pesach in the lands of the in the land of their captivity. They was in a bad shape. Go ahead. Go ahead. And turn it to Ezekiel chapter 38. Highlight verse 5, but go up to verse 1. Yezachiel say in verse 1, and the word of Yahweh came unto me, saying, Ben-Adam, son of man, set your face against Gog, the land of Magog, the chief prince of Meshech and Tubal, and prophesy against him, and say, thus saith Yahweh Elohim to the Scythians, behold, I am against ye, O Gog, the chief prince of Meshech and Tubal. Who was against them? Mashbekah. And I will turn thee back and put hooks in your jaws. Lachya. And I will bring thee forth and all thine army, horses and horsemen, all of them clothed with all sorts of armory, even a great company with bucklers and shields, all of them handling swords, Persia, Ethiopia, and Libya with them, all of them with shields and helmet. Gomer, the father of Ashkenaz, Gomer and all his bands, the house of Togomar of the north quarters, and all of his bands, and many people with thee. Be thou prepared and prepare for thyself, thou and all thy company that are assembled unto thee, and be thou a guard unto them. After many days, thou shalt be visited. So it's been a long time they've been over there. After many days, thou shalt be visited. In the latter days, in the Acharyat Hayawam, in the last days, thou shalt come into the land that is brought back from the war, that is brought back from war. After many days, thou shalt be visited in the Acharyat Hayawam, Hayamim. Thou shalt come into the land that is brought back by war and is gathered out of many people against the mountains of Yasharal, which have been always waste, but it is brought forth out of the nations, and they shall dwell safely, all of them. Thou shalt ascend and come like a storm. Thou shalt be like a cloud to cover the land, thou and all thy bands, and many people with thee. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim, it shall also come to pass that at the time shall that at the same time shall things come into your mind, O Gog, that thou shalt think an evil thought, and thou shalt say, I will go up to the land of unwell villages. Aha, aha, I will go to them that are at rest, that dwell safely. All of them dwell without walls, and having neither bars nor gates, to take a spoil and to take a prey, to steal and to take a prey, to turn thine hand upon the desolate places, you know, the places that are desolate, that are now inhabited, you know, the lands that are desolate right now that will be inhabited, and upon the people that are gathered out of the nations who were led as the captives, which have gotten cattle and goods, reparation, that dwell in the midst of the land, Sheba and Dedan, and the merchants of Tarshish, with all the young lions thereof, shall say unto you, art thou come to take a spoil? Hast thou gathered thy company to take a prey, to carry away silver and gold, to take away cattle and goods, to take a great spoil? Therefore, Barnadam, son of man, prophesy and say unto Gog, the father of Ashkenaz, Gog, thus saith Yahweh Elohim, in that day, when my people of Yasharal dwell safely, shall thou not know it? And thou shalt come, he asked them a question, shall you not know it when they dwell safely? Huh? Do they know that y'all ain't feeling safe right now? Will they not know it when you shall dwell safely? And thou shalt come from thy place out of the north parts, thou and many people with you, all of them riding upon horses, a great company and a mighty army, that thou shalt come up against my people of Yasharal as a cloud to cover the land. It shall be in the last days, in the Acharyath Hayawam, I will bring thee against my land, that the heathen may know me, when I shall be sanctified in thee, O Gog, before their eyes. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim, art thou he of whom I have spoken of in old time by my slaves, the prophets of Yasharal, which prophesied in those days many years that I will bring thee against them? You see, he told the prophets about this latter day prophecy of them in the last day doing this after Yasharal, who were led captives, will be brought back and dwell safely. And it shall come to pass at the same time when Gog shall come against the land of Yasharal, the Arats of Yasharal, saith Yahweh Elohim, that my fury shall come up in my face. For in my jealousy and in the fire of my wrath have I spoken. Surely in that day there shall be a great shaking in the land of Yasharal, so that the top of the sea, so that the fishes of the sea and the fowls of the Shamayam and the beasts of the field and all creeping things that creep upon the earth and all the Adam that are upon the face of the earth shall shake at my presence. And the mountains shall be thrown down, and the steep places shall fall, and every wall shall fall to the ground. And I will call for a sword against him throughout all my mountains, saith Yahweh Elohim. Every Adam, war shall be against his brother. And I will plead against him with pestilence and with blood, and I will rain upon him and upon his bands and upon the many people that are with him, and overflowing rain and great hailstones, fire and brimstone. Thus will I magnify myself and sanctify myself, and I will be known in the eyes of many nations, of many Gabayan, and they shall know that I am Yahweh. Therefore, thou son of man, prophesy against Gog and say, thus saith Yahweh Elohim, behold, I am against thee, O Gog, the chief prince of Meshech of Tubal, and I will turn thee back and leave but a sixth part of thee, and I will cause you to come up from the north parts and will bring you upon the mountains of Yasharal, and I will smite you, thy bow out of your hand. This is what Yahweh say. And I will cause thine arrows to fall out of thine hand. If we telling you what Yahweh said, and you say it's anti-Semitic, are you saying that we is Elohim, the creator of the heaven and the earth? Look up. Stop and look up and ask him, why is he going to do this to you? Thou shalt fall upon the mountains of Yasharal, thou and all thy bands and the people that is with thee. And I will give thee unto the ravenous birds of every sort and to the beasts of the field to be devoured. Thou shalt fall upon the open field, for I have spoken it, saith Yahweh Elohim. Who spoke it? Yahweh Elohim spoke it. BC, before Hamashiach came and died on the tree and rose again the third day. And I will send a fire on Magog and among them that dwell carelessly in the isles. And they shall know that I am Yahweh. So will I make my Kodash name known in the midst of my people, Yasharal. And I will not let them pollute my name anymore. And the heathen shall know that I am Yahweh, the Holy One of Yasharal. Behold, it is come. And it is done, saith Yahweh Elohim, because he spoke it, it shall not be void. This is the day whereof I have spoken, that they dwell in the cities of Yasharal shall go forth and shall set on fire and burn the weapons, both the shield and the buckler and the bows and the arrows and the hand staffs and the spears, and they shall burn them with the fire 7 years. If this don't happen, Elohim is a liar. So that they shall take no wood out of the field, neither cut down any of the forest, for they shall burn the weapons with fire, and they shall spoil those that spoiled them, and rob those that robbed them, saith Yahweh Elohim. And it shall come to pass in that day that I will give unto Gog a place. There are graves in Yasharal, the valley of the passages on the east of the sea. And it shall stop the noises of the passages. And there shall they bury Gog and all his multitude. They shall call it the valley of Hemagog. In the 7 months shall the house of Yasharal be burying of them, that they may cleanse the land. Yea, all the people of the land shall bury them, and it shall be to them a renown, the day that I shall glorify, shall be glorified, saith Yahweh Elohim. And they shall sever out men of continual employment passing through the land to bury with the passages those that remained upon the face of the earth, to cleanse it. After the end of 7 months shall they search. Is you going to get inside of the ark? Or is you still going to boast in your money? Are you going to get inside of the ark? Or are you going to boast in your possessions? Did not Yahweh speak through the prophet Yezekiel and many prophets whom our ancestors put to death because they told the truth? Which one of us is going to look at Yahweh in the face when he returns? When he judged the world with the bow of his mouth and boast and say that my money will save me and my wealth will be my salvation? Which one will step up in the valley of Jehoshaphat and boast in his power and in his armies? He said, gather over there. He said that he's going to judge at the last trumpet. Which one is the big boombasa that's going to run up on Yahweh Shai? Remember Lamentations chapter 5. Remember, O Yahweh, what has come upon us, and consider and behold our reproach, our inheritance, our possessions, our land, our language, our customs, our children, our inheritance is turned to strangers and our houses to aliens. We are orphans and fatherless. Our mothers are widows. We have drunken our water for money. Our wood is sold unto us. Our necks are under persecution. We labor and have no rest. We have given the hand of the to the Masriam. We have given the work, the labor to the Masriam and to the Assyrian to be satisfied with bread. Our fathers have sinned and are not. We are born their iniquities. Our slaves have ruled over us. There is none that doth deliver us out of their hand but one, Elohim. We got our bread with the peril of our lives because of the sword of the wilderness. Our skin was black, Negro, like an oven, like Hamashiach's skin was in the day that Yochanan saw him ascended and resurrected. Our skin, our war is black like an oven because of the terrible famine. They ravished the women in Sion and the maidens in the city of Yahabadah. Princes are hanging up their hand. The faces of the elders were not honored. They took the young men to grind at the mill, to grind, and the children fell under the wood. This nation that took us cared not about young or old, male or female. The elders have ceased from the gate, the young men from their music. The joy of our heart is ceased. Our dance is turned into mourning. Many people say it's shalom, shalom, but there is no peace. The crown is falling from our head. Our authority is gone unto us, that we have, because we have seen. For this our heart is faint, and for these things our eyes are dim. This is why our heart is faint, and this is why our eyes are dim, because of the mountain of Sion, which is desolate, the foxes walk upon it. Thou, O Yahweh, remainest forever, your throne from generation to generation. Therefore, dost thou forget us forever and forsake us so long time? Turn thou unto us, unto thee, O Yahweh, and we shall be turned. Renew our days as of old. But thou hast utterly rejected us. Thou art very wroth against us. Lamentation. Chapter 5. Now go to Lamentations chapter 4. Begin at verse 1. How is the gold become dim? How is the most fine gold changed? The stones of the sanctuary are poured out in the top of every street. The precious sons of Sion are comparable to fine gold. How are they esteemed as earthen pitchers? The work of the hand of the potter, even the sea monster, draw out the breast. They give suck to their young ones. The daughter of my people has become cruel, like the ostriches in the wilderness. Ostrich abandon their baby. They abandon their egg. The tongue of the suckling child cleaveth to the roof of his mouth. For thirst, the young children ask bread. For water, the young children ask. You ever been so hungry and thirsty that you ask for bread? And no man break it unto them. They that did feed delicately are desolate in disgrace. They that were brought up in scarlet embrace doo-doo piles. For the punishment of the iniquity of the daughter of my people is greater than the punishment of the sin of Saddam. Adam that was overthrown in a moment, and no hands stayed on her. Her nitsar. Her dread, her lock, the ones that, I'm going to just say it in modern day, the dreadheads were purer than snow, and their conduct. They were whiter than milk. They were more ruddy in body than rubies. Their polishing was as of sapphire. Their visage, their appearance is blacker than a coal. You know, the charcoals which y'all grill on the stove, their skin, their visage, their appearance are blacker than a coal. They are not known in the streets. Their skin cleaved to their bones. It is withered. It has become like a stick. They that be slain with the sword are better than they that are slain with hunger. For these pine away, stricken through for want of the fruit of the field. The hand of the pitiful woman have sodden their own children. They were their meat in the destruction of the daughter of my people. Yahweh have accomplished his fury. He have poured out his furious anger and have kindled a fire in Sion and it have devoured the foundations thereof. The Malach of the earth and all the inhabitants of the Arats would not have believed that the adversary and the enemy should have entered into the gate of Yerushalayim. For the sins of her Nabayathwa, her prophets, and the iniquity of her Kohan, priest, that have shed the blood of the just in the midst of her, all of the innocent blood from Habal all the way down to all of the prophets whom they slain in Yerushalayim. They are wandered as a blind man in the streets. They have polluted themselves with blood so that men could not touch their garments. They are cried unto them, depart ye, it is unclean, depart, depart, touch not. When they fled away and wandered, they said among the heathen, they shall no more sojourn there. The anger of Yahweh have divided them. Mother against daughter in law against mother, mother against daughter, son against father. How every your enemies will be those of your household. The anger of Yahweh have divided them. He will no more regard them. They respect not the persons of the Kohan, the priest. They favored not the elders, the Gadol. As for us, our eyes are yet filled for our vain help and our watching. We have watched for a nation, for a Galilean that could not save us, for a Gentiles that could not save us. They hunt our steps. We cannot go in our streets. Our end is near. Our days are fulfilled, for our end is come. Our persecutors are swifter than the eagles of the heaven. They pursue us upon the mountains. They laid wait for us in the wilderness. The breath of our nostrils, the anointed of Yahweh, was taken in their pits, of whom we said, under his shadow we shall live among the heathen. Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Ishal, of Edom, that dwellest in the land of Uz. The cup also shall pass through unto you. Thou shalt be drunken, and shall make yourself naked. The punishment of thine iniquity is accomplished, O daughter of Sion. He will no more carry thee away into captivity. So if this right here was talking about something that happened before Hamashiach, then why did Hamashiach and the other prophets, and also including Jeremiah, say in the last day we will be scattered into every nation as captives? This must be a Achariath Hayawam prophecy. He say, O daughter of Sion, he will no more carry thee away into captivity. He will visit thine iniquity, O daughter of Ishal of Edom. He will discover your sins. This is the time where people need to be getting the blood on their doorposts, but they too busy shedding innocent blood in the streets. This is the time for folk to be getting the blood of Hamashiach on their doorposts and for them to be in their house getting prepared for the feast. But instead, they are out slaughtering and killing innocent people. Obadiah. It's only one chapter. Obadiah. The vision of Obadiah. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim, and Shalom, Elder Obadiah, if you here today. The vision of Obadiah. Thus said Yahweh Elohim concerning Ishal, Edom. We have heard a rumor from Yahweh, and an ambassador is sent among the heathen. Arise ye, and let us rise up against her in battle. Behold, I have made you small among the heathen. Thou art greatly despised. People despise Ishal, Esau, our older brother. The pride of thine heart have deceived you, you that dwell in the clefts of the rock, whose habitation is high, that saith in his heart, who shall bring me down to the ground? Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle. What other verse did we just read about the eagle? Though thou exalt thyself as the eagle, and though thou set thy nest among the stars. Who is the stars that Yahweh saw in a vision. Joseph, thence will I bring you down, saith Yahweh. If thieves came to you, if robbers by night, there is a law that you are supposed to leave some fruits on the tree for gleaning. But I saw them. A lot of times, if you go out to the fruit grove, the people with the spirit of I saw, and some of them may even be I saw, they'll charge you $600 if you pick a fruit out of the orange grove. If thieves came to you, and if robbers by night, how art thou cut off? Would they not have stolen till they had enough? Now, the people that go inside of the vineyard to get the fruit, they not stealing. So how come it is a sin for the poor to glean in Ishaw's garden? If the grape gatherers come to you, Esau didn't even want to let our ancestors pass through the land. They cut us off. They didn't want us to pass through the land. Ishaw didn't like to let us pass through their land. When the nations of the north came down to capture us, they cut some of us off. They didn't let us pass through the land to escape. Would they not leave some grapes? How are the things of Ishaw searched out? How are the hidden things sought up? All the men of your confederacy, Ishaw, have brought you even to the border. The men that were at Shalom with you, Esau, they have deceived you. See, this ain't Ya'aqaba doing nothing to you. This is the people who Esau joined in the confederacy with and prevailed against you. They that eat thy bread have laid a wound under you. There is none understanding in him. Shall I in that day, saith Yahweh, even destroy the wise men out of Ishaw, and understanding out of the mount of Esau, the dukes, and thy mighty man, O Teman, shall be dismayed to the end that every one of the mount of Ishaw may be cut off by slaughter. See, Esau, your own people that you gather with to fight against your brother that didn't do nothing to you, those same people, Esau, for thy violence, this is why, for thy violence against thy brother, Ya'aqaba, shall cover you, and thou shalt be cut off forever. Esau, because of your transgression against your brother, Ya'aqaba, in these last days, in the day that thou stoodest in the other side, in the day that strangers carried away captive his forces, and foreigners entered into his gates and cast lots upon Yerushalayim, even thou was as one of them. But thou shouldest not have looked on the day of your brother, in the day that he became a stranger, neither shouldest thou have rejoiced over the children of Yahabadah in the day of their destruction. Neither shouldest thou have spoken proudly in the day of distress. Thou shouldest not have entered into the gate of my people in the day of their calamity. Yea, thou shouldest not have looked on their affliction in the day of their calamity, nor have laid hands on their substances in the day of their calamity. Neither shouldest thou have stood in the crossway to cut off those of his that did escape. Neither, you know, the ones that fled like Yahawashah told them to flee, Ishaw was cutting people off. Neither shouldest thou have delivered up those of his that did remain in the day of disgrace. Neither should you have been a slave catcher, Ishaw, to those who remained in the land. for the day of Yahweh is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto you. Thy reward shall return unto your own head. For as you have drunken upon my holy mountain, so shall all the heathen drink continually. What is the hope of the set apart nation who will be led captive in the last day by slave ship, as the prophet Masha spoke inside of the scripture? So shall all the heathen drink continually. Yea, they shall drink and they shall swallow down, and they shall be as though they had not been. But upon the mount of Sion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Yahweh shall possess their own possession. See, we have possessions, but right now, somebody else is possessing the possession. Who is going to do this? Who is this that cometh from Edom, whose garment will be dipped in blood? Yahweh Shai, who said, I will not repent of what I'm going to do. So who ship is you going to get in as you're going to anoint your doorpost with the blood of the Lamb, which is Yahweh Shai? Or are you going to follow after the world and not get inside of the ship? And the house of Yahweh shall be a fire, and the house of Yahweh a flame, Joseph, and the house of Ishal for stubble. That's where the stubble is going to be thrown. And they shall kindle in them and devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Ishal, for Yahweh has spoken it. Who spoke it? Who spoke it? Yahweh spoke it. Why did he speak it? Because of what they did to Yahweh. If they of the south, and they of the south shall possess the mount of Ishal, and they of the plain, the Philistines, and any other, and whatever people do, they storing up for themselves wrath against the day of wrath. If people knew, the people that they making all these evil laws against, if they knew really what they was doing, I wonder what they do it. And the captivity of the host of the children of Yasharal shall possess that of Canaan. You know what they called you, Canaanites? Under the Hamite curse, you shall possess that of Canaan, the Canaanite, even unto Zarephath, and the captivity of Yerushalayim, which is in Sephard, shall possess the cities of the south. And Moshiach shall come up on the Mount of Sion to judge the Mount of Ishal. Did not the apostle Shawal say, know ye not that ye shall judge Malachiyam? And the kingdom shall be Yahweh's. Amen. So when the ship sank, who is going to be ready to get on board? When the ship sank, who is going to be ready to ride the ship? Who is going to boast in their wealth? When Hamashiach come back, it's going to be like the blinking of an eye. You're not going to miss him. He's going to come in the day, in the hour, when the nobody is aware of. Because he's going to keep his promises. He told Daniel, seal up the book, for it is for the last days. In these last days, the understanding. See, a lot of people say, y'all being racist. Let me tell you something. I see that, sister. Let me tell you something, Mosh Bakar. How is you being racist? If you look inside of the lens where you at and you say, I'm this, I'm that. But you look inside the Bible and you look through the table of nations to try to find yourself. And you cannot find your name. So you say, okay, is there a prophecy of people who will lose their name and land and be slaves and be in slaveship in the last day? You read inside the book and you find out that there are some people who will be slaves in the last days. And there's a timeline after 70 AD. A group of people were being taken as slaves. The older slave masters called them Judeans. The wandering Jews, that's what they called them. So we looked in the prophets and saw the prophecy about a nation of people who will be taken as the property. That's what captives mean, as the property of other nations. And when they take them over there, they will sell one for a harlot. They will sell them for harlots, for wine. Did not the Hamite people take wine? Did not the slave catchers take wine to sell us to them people so we could be trafficked? Did not they sell our ancestors for wine? Were they not in the bottom of ships, as Masha spoke that they would be? He said that I know that you will not do what I ask you to do. So you shall be led captive into every nation. Your women will be made wenches. That's what is written. The word that was used for the slave, for the woman, it had wench. That word meant bed wenches. It meant slaves. It meant servants. So you was house servants, you was field Negroes, and you was bed wenches. For the men, you were made bucks, you was in the field, and you was in the house. Fulfillment of that prophecy, other prophecy. You will be scattered to by a nation that you do not yadai, that you are not acquainted with, that you do not know, like you know somebody, that you do not know these people. They will speak a language that you would not understand. Our ancestors did not understand what they were saying. Look up the record of Olauda Aquiano, how he gave testimony. And not just him, the brother that was practicing Muslim gave the same testimony about the people, that how he lost his language. This brother, this elder, gave testimony on how he lost his language in this captivity in the northern parts of America. He wrote letters in the Arabic tongue, trying to let his ancestors know how he prayed for them in this land, how that they will prosper over here, that we over here, so that he could try to help us to remember, to know who we is. Why was that important to that elder, Ibn? So you look at Olado Akuyanu, who said that the customs that the people that practice in the Bible was identical to the customs that they practiced in the land where they was. When you look over there in those lands are not even named the same names that Olauda Aquiano wrote down in his book. So there's been people rewriting names on maps, but there's records of people, even Gentiles, who recorded in the abolitionist movements things concerning the children of Yahawadah. There are Gentiles now today that's recording down things inside of their journals about the people of Yahawadah, how they waking up in these last days. How many Gentiles have opened their eyes and said, our fathers have inherited lies. We enslave the children of Judah. Mashpaka, get in the ship. When the ship is sinking, you need to get in one of them boats. Now, if we was all riding on the Titanic, and the way to be saved on the Titanic ship, Sister Private AC and True Self K, if one of y'all was Rose and the other one was one of somebody else that's going to be saved, like the little children, wouldn't y'all go to the one that bought you as they new slave so that you could get on the ship, that you could get on the raft, on the boat, so that you could be saved from the water, be saved from the judgment, so we all need to be making our way to the ship. Who is the ship? Yahawashi. He purchased us with his blood. That's why when he called you servant, that word translate abid, abad. That means you are his abad now. You don't belong to the slave master. You're not on the Washington plantation no more. Abar people change their names for a reason. You don't belong to the Jones plantation no more when you receive Yahawashi. You don't belong to the Hamite that bought you. You don't belong to nobody that bought you when you receive Yahawashi. You belong to Yahawah, because Yahawashi bought you. He purchased you with his blood so that he could give you to the Father. That was the purpose, that he could glorify his Father and his Father glorify his Son. This is what we need to be doing, figuring out how to get in the ship. Who is the way and the truth and the life? Yahawashi, Yahi, Hawa exists, salvation. He, our salvation. He, salvation. Yahi, Hawashi, salvation. He, salvation. Yah, Hawa, he exists. Hawa exists. Yah, he, Aman. Yah, Hawa is our salvation. Let me pull up, because my wife told me somebody on Facebook asked me, why do I say Yahawah and Yahawashi? I'm going to look up this verse. Mashpaka, thank y'all for coming. I'm going to look up this verse right here for them so that they would know why I say Yahawah and Yahawashi. So let me go back so that our family can know what's going on. I got books. Hold on, let me get the book. There's some spaceships riding up right now. I don't know why they do that every day, but hey, that's just something they do in their pastime, I reckon. But if y'all hear that rumbling and shaking, that's spaceship. That's a spaceship going up. All right. They go up all the time. All right, so. There go the books. I found my books. All righty. All right. Now let me go to my Bible. Phoenician Hebrew scriptures. There we go. There we go. All righty. Now let me pull that up. Shalom, Mother April Shower. All right, do y'all see that? And I put a African brother voice on there. Let me let y'all hear the African brother talk before I start. So that's the African brother talking. Let him read this one right here. Let's see. All right. Now, I told y'all last time, I said Barashayath, Bara, Alahayam. See that right there? In the beginning, created Alahayam, Ath, Hashamayam, heaven, Wa Arats, Wa Ath, sign, heaven, Ha'adats, Ha'arats, and earth, heavens and earth, Wa'af, Ha'arats, heavens and earth. So it say right here, Bara Shayath, Bara Shayath. In your King James Bible, you read, in the beginning, Bara Alahayim. It's saying, your King James Bible, in the beginning, G-O-D created the heavens and the earth. And the Phoenician Hebrew is Barashayath, Bara, Alahayam, Atha, Hashamayam, Wa, Af, Ha'arats, heavens and the earth. All right. So now let me go down to where y'all can see Alahayam name, Mashbaka. I'm showing her now, sweet pea. Hold on, let me go to that so I can pause it for you. All right, Mashbaka, I'm back. All right, so let's go to Barashayath. All right, that's Barashayath chapter 5. You look at your KJV Bible. You'll read it in English, but I'm trying to find Yahweh name. So let's go to Abraham. All right. So Abraham, when he spoke about the last days and Barashayath. So let's go up to Abraham. All right. All right. So that is Barashayath, I think, last chapter. He's going to say Yahweh's name. And it's all throughout Barashayath, but I know exactly that it's in the last chapter of Barashayath. And I will leave this link under the video, Yahweh willing, when I get done, Mashbaka. All right, so let's go to 40. Okay, 40. Where we at? Okay, 42. All right. Let's see, in this Bible here, they might have more chapters that we don't know about. Let's see. Say 46. Barashayah 47. 48, Barashayah 49, Barashayah 50, and then you go to Sapar Ya Taza'a Tha, I can't remember that letter, but let me go up to Yahweh name so y'all can see it. So this is in Barashayath 50. All right, so when I get to Yahweh name, I'm going to stop. So let me sound out these letters best as I can. And then when I get to Yahweh's name, I will stop. Okay, I forgot what this one is. Let me see. That's Pa. Okay. Wayapala. Wayapala. Ya. Wa sap Ayla, Panai, Panai, Abayawa, Wa, Yapaz, Wayabats, Bats, Ailayawa, Waya, Shakwa, Lawa, Ya, Waya. Let me skip. Let me see. I know his name somewhere in here. Oh man, they shooting them things up. I know y'all heard that. I know y'all heard that. But it say Banai, that's son. Man, why they shooting them things up like that? Let's see. Hold on, Mashbaka. Let me look up a verse real quick. I'm going to go directly to his name. Okie dokie dokie. So let's go to Barashaya. And let's see. And they say, let's go to, okay. Because even Adam and Hawa knew his name. Hey, poop, poop. All right. So Yahweh rested from all the work he made. And then they say, okay, right there. And they say, when they say L-O-R-D, that's what his name is at. So I'm going verse 4 of Barashayath chapter 2. Verse 4 of Barashayath chapter 2. Then I'm finna read his name, Mashbaka. And if y'all have any things y'all want to say on this, y'all can do so after I get done with this. All right, so Barashayath chapter 4. Remember, in our book, there was no chapters and verses. It was just Barashayath, and then you had all these letters right here. All right, so in Barashayath, so in the King James Version, they say 2 and verse 4. These are the generations of the Shamayam and of the Arats of the earth when they were created, when they were bara, in the day that Yahweh Alahayim. So right there, it says both. It says his name and his position. So let's go here. Verse 4. Let's find verse 4. All right. And you start over here. Hashabah. Hashabah. Yai. Waya. Quadash. Atawa, Tazaya, Bawa, Shabath, Matazala, Mala, Mala, Tasatawa, Ashara, Bara, Allah, Hayam, Alahayam, La, I, Shawa, Shawa. So, where is Yahweh? Because they say when they translated it, they would put the capital L O R D and then put Alahayam, where his name is supposed to be. So, I don't see where it say Yahweh. So let me see. So Barashayath chapter 80. No, let's go to Psalms, because I know it said clearly in the Psalms. Psalms 83, where it's talking about a latter day prophecy, and you could go and look that up. All right, so go to Psalms. Let me stop this. Okay, let me stop the voice and look up this right here. So let's go to Psalm. Psalms 83. And it show you what page it's on. All right. I'm going to share this with your family when I'm done. Y'all can go and play around with this book and study it. All right. So it say page 483. So let's go down to Psalms. Page 483. There we go. So that's the proverb. Why are we in proverb? Let's say 483 was song. All right, there we go. So let's go to 83rd song. And you should see your Yahweh name at the bottom. So 83rd song. And these all was books, like just regular scrolls, and they say songs on them, and they just compilated them and put them together. But all of these were their own books, Mash Picasso. Like when you had the book of Obadiah, was its own scroll. These was all in their own scrolls, and they just put them together in order, like in the order that they saw where they wanted to put them. But that's why they call the books of songs, but some people just call them the Psalms, like I just did. All right, so right here, if you got your King James Bible, right here in the last verse, in Ta'alayam 83, go down in your Bible if you got a KJV and look at verse 18. And it say, that the men may know that thou, whose name alone is, they put Jehovah, art the Most High over all the earth. But in Phoenician Hebrew, there was no J, there was no E, there's no O, and there is no V. So how do you say this? Yah, Ha, Wah. And right here, you see it. That's the Yod, that's the Ha, that's the Wah, which is Wawa, which means Wawa, it means like you got a Wawa mark. Wawa means like a hook, like a fish hook. Ha. So you have Ya, which means hand. Ha, which means horizon. Wa, which symbolizes a fish hook, as you can see it right here. Ha, which symbolizes a hand lifted up in praise. The root word for yod is hand, work, salvation, right? Work, salvation. A lamad symbolizes the staff. Ha, so it has yah, which also means he, yah, ha, wa. So if you put this word hawa together, it means exist. This means exist. So you say Yah, He, Hawa, exist. And what Yahweh Shai means, He exists, salvation. So when it says Yahweh salvation, Yahweh gave Yahweh Shai His name, His reputation, His name. Yahweh Shai carried His legacy, His identity, because He's the son of Elohim. A son is supposed to carry the legacy of his father and not supposed to make his mother wish that he wasn't born. He's supposed to honor his father and his mother. Yah, Ha, Wah, that's his name right there. And Yahweh Shai's name also is in the old covenant as well. I'm not finna go over that today, Mosh, but matter of fact, let me do that. So if you want to see Yahweh Shai, one, there's a prophet who has Yahweh Shai's name. We call him Hosea, Mashbakah. His name is Hosea. All right, I'm finna do this. Then I'm finna come and ask questions y'all want to give. Y'all want to answer any questions or whatever, ask questions or have any statements. When I get done with this, you have the liberty to do that. And this is Bara, creation. It says, in conjunction with Bet Hashem, which means the name Midrash, the order of the books and the divisions of verses. I'm going to drop this in the link for y'all in this edition. And I'm going to drop it in the PDF link where y'all could go ahead and download it. Or you could go to their website and purchase the book. If you download it, if you purchase the book, they make it available for you. But you have to create an account. Leave you. Here is the website right here. Make sure you moderators, if you can, write this down. HTTP, or I just post it in the chat so that the family can know the company that's doing this right here. All right. So let me copy that for you. And then y'all can go and fill out an account. So right here, Hosea. You see that, Hosea? Now, remember, Hosea means salvation. And I'm going to prove it to you. Hosea means salvation. So that's page 648. So you go to page 648. Boom. There go Hosea. All right. Look at this. Hawa Shai. Hawa Shai. In Yahweh's prayer, Yahweh Shai said this right here. I'm finna quote the prayer to you. And I dropped that link inside of my community tab when I'm done. But I'm finna quote the prayer to you. Before I do that, let me quote the prayer real quick. Mashbakar. And I drop that down in the community tab. So when you download the Learn Ancient Hebrew Paleo Hebrew app that I'm going to send you a link to with the thing, you'll be able to go and look into. You might want to start with the letters first. And then you go into increased prayers. And this is where you'll find, we'll say, the L-O-R-D prayer. It says right here, Palal Yahweh, Yahweh's prayer. Let me let it read it out to you. Hopefully you can hear. Hold on.
Which is in heaven, holy be your name, Abba Noah, Shabashimayom, Kwadish HaYashimka.
So it's a real app, Mashbaka. All right. So let me exit that and let me read to you the prayer and drop back into the thing right there. So y'all see that say Habashai, right? So I'm finna read to you Yahweh's prayer. It says, Anash Ayanaya. My eyes, I will lift up my eyes. That's the wrong one. Let me see. Yahweh's prayer. There it go. Abba Yanawa, Shaba, Shamayam. That means our Father who art in heaven. Kwadash, Haya, Shemaka. Your name, your holy name. Shalak, Wataka, Taba'a. Your kingdom. Ratazawa Naka, your will be done. Ba Arayatsa, Ba Arayat, Ba Aratz in earth. Kawa Haya, Ba Shamayam, as it is in heaven. Nathan La Nawa, Laham Kala Yawam, and give us. And give to us bread all day. Wasalach nawa chawabawaf, and forgive us our debts. Katsalach wa nawa chawabawaf ya nawa, as we forgive our debtors. Wala Daba Ya'anawa, and it says and not bring us Bana Saya Sawan in temptation, but watch this, Abal Hawashai, but deliver us. Abal Hawashai, but deliver us. Abal means but, Hawashai means deliver us, save us. So when you say Yahweh and you say Hawashai, it means deliver us. So Yah, he is our salvation. Yahweh, deliver us. Yahweh's savior. Yahweh's salvation. Man means from. Rai, evil. Deliver us from evil. Kayalaka, Hamalakawath. For to you the kingdom. Wa ha'Allah and the power. Wa ha'Allah, wa ha'tapa, the pa arath and the glory. La I walam yam aman, forever aman. All right, I'm finna come back, family. All right, I hope that y'all heard me clearly. Whoo, that was a lot. But I had to get that out for the Mashpaka. Thank y'all, family, for coming out. And okay, you good. I ain't worried about this stuff. But yeah, y'all seek for Yahweh Shai. Don't worry about what everybody else got going on. Y'all seek for Yahweh Shai and get y'all household in order. Make sure y'all go out. And if you're gonna celebrate the Pesach, you're going to celebrate the Pesach, go and get your lambs. If you are able to go on the farm and get one, you know, a year old, a male lamb. And at the night, and I believe it's going to be on the 14th, it's the day of preparation. And at nightfall, that is Arab Tawab. That is the twilight. That's when the night getting ready to fall. That's when you start, when it's getting dark, that's when you take your grill out. You don't bake it in the stove. You don't do that. You take your grill out, get your charcoals, whatever you're going to use. You don't boil it in water, but you put it on there and you bake him on your, you know, and get him prepared. Get that lamb prepared and you have you some. Get you some unleavened bread and get you some bitter herbs. There's some bitter herbs. And I believe Sister Malaka said that she's going to do a list for y'all to go and see the bitter herbs, the different kinds y'all could choose from. Get y'all some bitter herbs. And when y'all go in the house, you don't come out. Excuse me. Sorry. You don't come out. You stay in there all night long until Bawakar, you could come out the door. So in the morning, Bawar, you could come out in the morning. So at the evening, when the sun is getting ready to come up or whatever, that's around the time when you're getting ready to be able to go outside. When you eat the food real fast, you know, because the children of Yasharah, when we was in Masrayim and we was in bondage over there, what we did is that we had to hurry up and eat the food real fast because the death angel was passing through and we was getting ready to leave in the morning. And whatever foods that you could not eat, you burnt up all of that. So I don't know if y'all want to burn up all the food up on the grill. So take going and get only enough that you can eat for a household and whatever the other person, you go and you share with your neighbors that want to celebrate it or whatever. And y'all divide it as much as the household. This is what the prophet Masha said. And did you know that they were selling Pesach when Hamashiach, and they call that the Last Supper. So I don't know why people saying we can't celebrate Pesach, but we celebrating Easter, Thanksgiving, and all this. No, don't worry about the bunny laying no egg. Don't worry about that. Go and buy you a lamb, buy you some lamb meat, and I don't know if they let you, but I just know for sure you could get lamb meat. And if there's somebody that know about this more, they might know that you could get some goat meat or whatever, but I would be careful to get lamb meat. And you put that on the stove, you put that on the grill, and you grill it until it's done. You grill the herbs. You don't boil, you don't cook it. You know, you don't boil the lamb in the stove and all that. You take it outside and you bake it. You know, you want to have your stuff lined up, and that's what you're going to eat for 7 days. You're going to eat unleavened bread. You're going to eat, we got lamb. And you want to get your bitter herbs. You want to eat those and get you something to drink, water, however you're going to do it. And for 7 days, this is how you celebrate. All right. And if y'all are willing, I'll be back up here tomorrow. If y'all willing, after I look more into it, this is as far as I study with that. If I look more into it and see what happens after the 7 days, is that all we do is stay in the house those whole 7 days. I can't never go out. But I remember when Mariam and the other Mariam went out to the tomb with the frankincense to bury, to properly embalm Yahweh Shai body like the Masriam do, because our customs were closely linked to the Hamitic tribes, the Kemet people. So we would embalm the bodies and whatnot. And so Mariam and the other Mariam went to embalm him. So that was the day where they were able to go and embalm him on the third day. So you count from 14. So from the nightfall and then the 14th night, that's when you is, you know, remember when Hamashiach was doing the prayer and all that. So you got to remember this. We got to get prepared for this Pashach. And Pastor Kelly did a message about the Pashach and the timeline. And whatever I may have erred in, I'll share that with you, family, under this video. And y'all can go and make sure that the preparations and things is right. Read in Barashayath, Exodus chapter 12. So let me put Exodus. Read Exodus 12. It'll tell you about the feast. All right. There we go. Hopefully I got that spell right. But there it go right there, family. It goes Shemot 12. Please share this broadcast if you can. And pass the word to our people that we got to get in this Passover and celebrate. We don't know when Hamashiach coming, but we do know that his coming is near, you know, because the captives already been led captive. We waking up in the lands of our captivity as the prophet said we would. And now we need to be getting people inside of the house. We need to start, you know, seeking for Yahweh. And we need to wait on our Jubilee family. We're not going to do anything. Yahweh's going to do it. And we need to be patient and wait on Yahweh until his wrath is appeased on us. When he get done spanking us, then he going to deal with everybody else. And if they didn't want to get inside of the house, that last trumpet blow, that's it. So, family, I got to go. I hope somebody got something out of this. If there are any other questions, anything, please let me know before I get off of here. I'll drop the link just in case y'all want to come up. And that'll be it, fam. Here we go. And I want to say, I said live viewer come and show up. I don't know what's going on here. But they go to Link Mashpaka. Let me take that down. All right. No, you good, Mashpaka. You good. Y'all good. Don't worry about that. All right. I want to say give a salute to the family that came. Shalom, Moshe, the commentator. Shalom, Masha. You change your name. All right, Masha. Moshe, the commentator. I like that. Sister Naomi. Shalom, sister. Sister Naomi changed her name too. I like that name, Sister Naomi. Maybe one day y'all will show me what write down what y'all name mean. Shalom, Sister Malaka Adiga, thank you for coming, sister. Who else we got here? Sister Private C, Shalom to you, sister. It's a blessing for you to be here, sister. As always, I want to say Shalom to you. And again, Mother Ama April Showers, Shalom to you, Ama. Thank you for coming. And Shalom, True Self K, Free DRC CD. All right, Mash Prakash, Shalom, thank you for coming. And we have a special guest here today, Shalom MK Mobile Gaming in the Philippines. Shalom to you, Mash Prakash. I'm glad that y'all came. I pray that y'all come back and we can fellowship more. But Mash Prakash, I'm about to roll up out of here. I hope that y'all was blessed by something that I said today. And I want to just leave with this track right here before I go, Mash Prakash. All right. I'm going to leave with a track before I go. Let me make sure I got it set up correct. Yep. So I'm going to leave with this track.
There's plenty sisters missing and plenty being abused. But when you look on TV, it don't be in the news. So what we gonna do is we gonna stand by and keep a gender war while watching people die. Now it's pretty easy to pretend that we figured out, but we can never really push a little baby out. Our sisters being here, my brother through thick and thin, through the wickedness, yeah, even the same sin. There's no pain on this earth can compare to the way that it feels when the mother giving birth to baby. People trying to fake it, but can never duplicate it. It's a whole lot of haters on this earth. Fake it, they can take another reason I don't understand. I'ma make a rape a lady, and he's been 9 months as a baby in his mama belly. I'm sorry for the pain and the suffering that you've been through. I wish I could do more for the right in this.
Don't you cry.
You got a brother here. You got a hug here. You got a brother here, sister. You got a hug here. Say, don't you give up. Say, don't you give up. You got a brother here. You got a brother here. You got a brother, you zesty and they young, clean, acting in the character. What you see is what you getting at the mass hysteria. But who the people? We the people. We belong to all the high post of worship. I'm a shire, but we calling on that higher. Says your grand boy, she a leading many to the fire. So that whip a crap, a lack up to the shadow. Man, I'm sick and tired of waiting, searching, looking for somebody to kill. Danger everywhere. Every time we turn another murder, stuck up in his hell phone, waiting on that chain to come. Gotta do our time, but I wanna be free now. It ain't safe, no place on the earth. We get it beat down on the folk corner many ways. Let's pray this track. Get ready for the people to be praying for the sheep. Be standing for the weak, seeking to lift the weak. Who been beaten by this wicked system? Although the people of the land of Yashua led captive on the folk corner soon to return. Be encouraged. You got a brother here. You got a hug here. You got a brother here, sister. You got a hug here. Say, don't you give up. Say, don't you give up. You got a brother here. You got a brother here. You got a brother here.
Shalom, Mash Prakash. Ahaba. Achwatya. Achyam.